wondered how vets know exactly how much medicine to give your pet? It's all thanks to math. Today, we're going behind the scenes of an animal hospital to uncover the amazing math skills that help veterinarians save lives and keep our furry friends healthy. Get ready for a wild ride full of numbers, science, and cuddly creatures. Let's get into it!
Doodly doodle, doodly doodle, doodly doodles and digits. Area, symmetry, fractions too, it's all here for you.
Hi, my name is Dr. Jennifer Zablakis. I'm a small animal veterinarian. I work at the Animal Hospital of Worthington.
Some of the things that veterinarians do are give checkups, diagnose illnesses, treat injuries, perform surgeries, give medicine, and also give advice to pet owners. How do you use math?
Math is part of every day as a veterinarian. From every appointment that comes in, we start out by getting the pets on a scale to see what they weigh today. We have to prescribe medication. We need to make sure that the dosing is precise so it's safe for them. You know, medications are going to be the biggest thing. Dogs and cats can get colds, or they might have antibiotics like we would at home, and we have to make sure those are measured properly. If they get too much, could give them an upset stomach. If they get too little, it might not do the job and get rid of the infection that it needs to. One thing that can happen a lot with sick animals is if they're coming in for an upset stomach. And a lot of times, if you've had an upset stomach, you're gonna also be dehydrated. We do have ways to kind of estimate how dehydrated a pet is in different percentages. And based on if we say they're 5% or 7% dehydrated, that's gonna affect how we calculate how much fluids they need to help get them rehydrated and get them feeling better.
Do you use decimals?
We do use decimals going out a couple places at least. From there, we'll usually just round up. We do use rounding all the time for their weights, but also when we're drawing up medication that's a liquid, we use syringes that just have the marked increments on it. We can only take that down to such a small amount, so we do typically have to round up. They get measured on digital scales that we weigh them in pounds, but from almost all of our medical drugs and dosing of things, we do convert to metrics. There's a lot of converting pounds to kilograms.
What type of tools do you use?
We definitely use calculators. We use scales, both a large scale that the bigger animals can just stand on, and we have a smaller scale for cats and small dogs that they just sit on up on the table. We use these little calipers that have metric measurements on it to measure lumps and bumps and maybe even wounds that are on dogs. And we have a tool that kind of works as like a big caliper that we actually can put on their body that we measure for our patients when we're getting ready to take x-rays of them. A lot of monitors, we're keeping a check on their heart rate, their respiratory rate. Dentistry is a really big part of our practice, and it's a really big part of keeping your pet healthy. Just like you and I brush our teeth every day, our dogs do not. So dogs and cats actually need that too, because everything they eat, that plaque kind of builds up. And we do full dental procedures where they do have to be under general anesthesia, so they can't, you know, bite our fingers or don't like having that stuff put in their mouth, but they get scaled and polished, and we even take full x-rays of all of their teeth so we make sure nothing's missing, nothing's broken. But we do have a regular x-ray machine that we can look at depending on what part of the body we're measuring. If a dog has a cough, they have to measure the size of the chest, and we have to have the size right so that the radiation used for the x-rays penetrates it properly so we can see everything we need to see.
My dog Biscuit weighs 11.7 pounds. The vet needs to round his weight to the nearest pound. What is Biscuit's weight rounded to the nearest pound? Eleven point seven, rounded to the nearest pound, is 12 pounds. Biscuit's weight rounded to the nearest pound is 12 pounds. Did you get it correct?
One thing that's kind of interesting when you go to school to be a veterinarian, even if you think you only want to work on dog and cat, we have to learn all the different species. And there's definitely big differences between a large animal vet and a small animal, but everybody kind of has to get that baseline. Some people end up working in zoos with exotic animals. Every animal kind of comes with its own little quirks and things you need to know about them. So it's a lot of information. Yes.
Have you ever seen a chicken?
I have never seen a chicken in practice. Yep, I've never worked on a chicken. My name's Dr. Jennifer Zablakis, and this is How It's Math.
Want more information about how math is used in the real world? Make sure you check out our website, www.doodleslearning.com. Bye!
Is it good?